life as an athlete revolves around three major components. Talent, which is mandatory. Without that, you can't survive. Dedication and commitment, it complements, because with that dedication and commitment, you tend to realize you can survive and you feel that you belong there. But the most important thing, which in today's DNA, the ideal support, so we call it support for sports people, is the evolution of science in sport. That's a standout point for me because that relates to a lot of physical literacy. Physical literacy is the motivation, confidence, physical competence, knowledge, understanding to value and take responsibility for engagement in physical activities for life. I think it is very, very relevant for you to understand what all it takes for you to realize your body, your body mechanism, biomechanics of your body, your strengths and weaknesses, because that determines an opportunity for you to go that extra yard, that one percenter we call it in sport. If you manage to go that one percenter, science has given us the feedback to allow us to push ourselves, push the envelope to have that one percenter. If we take back a little bit, nurturing talent at the grassroots level, how do you start it? Where do we start it? It starts at a school level. Most importantly, the importance of physical literacy is very, very relevant at the school. We have a big challenge in India, technically, whereby the awareness of physical literacy or the physical education period is irrelevant in most of the schools. The government is taking key initiatives. It has started by introducing an integrated curriculum at CBSE board right now. But even today, we are a one-person, one-sport activity country. If you compare that with the Western world, they have minimum three-sport participation for every child. And we are facing that as a challenge because we don't indulge into an activity with a structured manner. There is no proper plan. There is no proper guidance, and the activity are not mapped. And that results into a lot of challenges at an early age. Just to give you some stat, 20% and more of our youth is suffering from diabetes, mental illness, all the health problems, because they are not being physically active. Physical activity boosts a lot of confidence. It gives you different comforts. But more importantly, it addresses all the concerns which we spoke about just now. In my opinion, if you encourage every child to actively participate in sport, it will eliminate that problem considerably, because that gives you a motivation, a determination, and a winning attitude, which matters the most for you to survive in life. If you compare that with the Western world, the ability to get engaged into sporting activities just around the corner. In India, we struggle that with peer pressures. Parents need to address that, so do the child, because it's very, very important to realize what are the correct measures you need to take, because that inculcates discipline habits, it gives you self-confidence, it allows you to understand how to accept failure and bounce back from the failure. It's very, very relevant for all of us to make sure that those key components are integrated into our system. And this gives you confidence to perform or make a right decision when you're under pressure. Because this particular aspect and certain alarming numbers, if I just throw at you, are some crazy numbers. In 2012 alone, diabetes caused 1.5 million deaths. It's crazy. I mean, if you make me believe that these numbers are, I've sourced it from all the open platforms. But more importantly, this gives us a realization where India can lead to if we don't address these particular problems. If you don't improve your lifestyle, if you don't improve your physical activities, if you don't improve all the areas which are concerning, then it's going to lead to a health disorder which are related to major, major concerns for our lifestyle. And this culture needs to change. If you compare that with the Western world, this is unreal. The obese people globally increased from 857 million in 1980 to 2.1 billion in 2013. Some staggering numbers for our reference. Crazy for us to make us believe that what are we heading into? Health habits, eating habits, all the technical challenges, all are the concerns in which we have to make sure that this is where we need to pull up our socks and focus on the areas which can be improved. I'll just give you a parallel and a compare. When I started playing cricket, that was a long time ago, in early 90s, when I broke into Mumbai team. Funnily, we never had a support staff. We never had that luxury of the support staff offering you all the help which is required. So all we had was one coach and a physio slash trainer who would fill into all the jobs. So if you go to him, I've got a sore hamstring, or I just pulled my quads muscle. These are the words I've learned it after that. I'm just referring it now. But if I go, I have a stiff, this thing. So he would say, pop up a pill, a painkiller. I said, you'll be fine the next day. So that was our rehab. Ice laga lo, theek ho jayega. Boss, I mean, is there an injury? Don't know, we'll do it tomorrow. Because you were a junior, you were bullied as well. And that's when you realize, what is this? I mean, if you're bowling 30, 40 overs in a day, and again the next day you have to still do that, your bowling muscles, you don't know what your bowling muscles are. What is rotator cuff? These were alien words for us. Then we started playing cricket. The only activity they would just get us into, just go for 5 laps of the ground, you'll be fine. Just stretch your arms and just go to bowl. That was our plan of action. And then suddenly now you compare that, you have all the needle therapies, the cupping therapies. I hope you know, in our days, the cup was only for a chai cup. And now you see that the cupping therapy gives you a complete rehab program. And Michael Phelps is a classic example. I'm sure you all have seen him in the Olympics, that all this cup therapy just on his body. And suddenly you realize, boss, where is this heading? But this gives you a reality check that it is very, very important and a relevant thing for you to upgrade yourself, and the technology and the science who've evolved globally has given you an advantage to analyze things, help the performers excel better. That is very, very relevant. Physiotherapist, coach, masseuse, gym trainer, strength and conditioning coach, mentor, these were the alien words when we started playing cricket. It was non-existence for us. Now, it's a reality. You talk about a sport like kabaddi, you have at least 10 people. They come from an absolute humble and a remote background, don't have a clue. The technical challenge which every Indian faces, especially coming from that humble background, you compare that with the Olympic sport, WADA gives you a list of the banned drugs to be avoided. How many of the doctors and trainers are oriented of those banned substances when they are partnering or associating with those trainers, athletes, or the complete troop support staff? That's where I feel an opportunity is for everybody of you doctors to get a career for yourself in sports. Because that's the need of the hour. If you relate that, who are these people who actually can give you, upgrade yourself? In India, unfortunately, we lack a lot of research work. In India, unfortunately, we lack a lot of opportunities getting created in this particular space. Why? Because we are not diving deep into this to make sure that we get real-time data. We come from such a diverse background across India, south, north, east, west, and everybody is tuned to different lifestyles. How do we get them to focus on one particular goal with that diverse background? North people will not relate to South technical challenges. We need scientific data to support that. We need a lot of activities which can get engaged ourselves into. And once we have that kind of a real-time data, this will allow us to improve our athletes perform better when they compete at the highest level. The good part is, now that it is evolving considerably. When you talk about the mental conditioning part, the psychologists, sports psychologists, the importance of sports psychologists has come to light in last 10, 15 years, maybe more so due to from the Western world influence. And the reason why I say Western world influence, You talk about the top athletes in the world, and trust me, I've been part of those, some of the incidents myself. When you are, just imagine yourself, you're playing a Wimbledon final. How do you prepare yourself? You're scared. You are frantically thinking what to do, how to prepare. All those thoughts go into mind. But then you have somebody else to guide you. Remember, stay calm. Job on the hand, stay in the present. Don't think about the future. Don't think about what you've done in the past. All the majors are just kept aside. This is your moment. If you stay in the present, this all sounds good. But when you are in the middle, all those thoughts just go blank. And you need to start thinking about the job on the hand. That's when this entire support staff comes into play. Your dietitian gives you a complete dietary plan. You are tempted to eat a burger a day before the match. It's a human tendency. Oh, I feel like eating a burger or a chips or a fries. But dietitians say you're not allowed to do that. Because at that point of time, his job is to get you tuned to the job on the hand to make sure that you deliver the best and achieve the desired goal. Imagine you are on the golf course. In the final round, there's unreal pressure. And for that last putt, you have to think about that particular moment with the dive, with the deep and the steep, everything you have. And suddenly you realize, oh God. Or for that matter, I'm sure you all will remember Mahendra Singh Dhoni's six in that World Cup. He looked so calm. But just imagine the 10,000 thoughts going in his mind to make sure that he just wipes those thoughts and focus on that one particular thing that I have to finish this match and win that for India. Or for that matter, Joginder Sharma's last over in that 2007 World Cup. It wasn't easy for him when he got hit for a six to come back into that zone and make sure that you bowl under pressure. That's when all these mental conditioning coaches, the support staff, which are now emerging as a good option for athletes to survive and to make sure that delivered what is expected from them. Because those professional skills can only be enhanced with all that support staff, which is a luxury now for all the teams. Forget cricket. Cricket is fairly organized, but you talk about other sport now, they are improving a lot. Since the time IPL was introduced, India has seen an emergence of leagues. 13 to 14 leagues have been introduced now. So there is a fundamentally huge opportunity. If you just go by the stat that FICCI Council's released the report, by 2022, in a sports science and technology space, India requires more than 10 lakh manpower. It's not me. It's FICCI's report. It's available on the public domain. Sports coaching requires more than 4.5 lakh trained professionals. Sports medicine requires 4.25 lakh professionals. Even if you discount that by 50%, look at the opportunities currently are getting created in the industry. For me, that's a positive side. For me, these are the key areas where you can actually make a career for yourself. I'll refer to a couple of incidences where India is still not accepting that as vis-a-vis Western world. A couple of English players who went on and accepted that they have a mental problem. They have an anxiety issue. They have a challenge of fear of failure. They sought help from the professionals to overcome those problems. And that's when they went all that to drawing board, took all the help which was required, and came back stronger as a performer and went on to go to represent that their country again. For me, this practice needs to get into India's system. I'm not saying that we don't have a problem, but we are still not open to accept those as problems. This is where we need to break that myth. This is where we need to start analyzing where all can go wrong and what all needs is required to improve upon that for the end result, which is the performance. There were a couple of career options across the field, but I feel eventually the industry, when it grows, the opportunities will keep coming. For us, as Indians, we are a sport-loving country. If you have to find a transition from a sport-loving country to sport-playing country, globally, all the top countries are the sport-playing countries. We need to find that transition path to improve upon ourselves and make sure that India becomes a powerful country and send a strong message. By Khelo India Youth Game, India have activated that, allowing all the youngsters to come together, given them a platform to perform that, and showcase their talent. The numbers need to increase in terms of the Olympic sport participation. With all that help, which can be offered from the science space, from the research, to support upgradation, this is when we will find a difference, and we will bring that difference into that. As a humble initiative, 3 years back, we introduced something as a social initiative, and we wanted to give a message by getting all the youngsters, especially the young youth of India, to come together and be more physically fit. And one of the key initiatives I feel can be sent out as a social message is apne bachcho ke pairon ko apne desh ki mitti lagne do. I'd like to sign off with that. Thank you.